studied interior design at the School of Architecture. Site-specific design, and because this is already built, so they could not affect or touch the walls, and whatever they created had to comply with the codes of fire safety. So it was an interesting project for them. They did learn a lot about talking to a client and also talking to the people that regulate codes and the oversee for the safety. They learn about that, what they could do, the limitations and budget. And now they're building their proposals real scale instead of, usually we work with models, but instead of making a model of that space, we're building it life size. Out of cardboard, we cannot afford the materials that they're proposing. But it's going to give an idea of what the space will look like when the items that are put are affecting the space. It is a very, the Planetarium area, even though it's a beautiful space, it's a, as you see, a multi-story height space, it's a very difficult to work because there are many functions. And one of the main ones, as we have the children passing by behind my back, is the daily show of the Planetarium pass. And that also, it's sort of conflicts with the amount of people that are passing to cross, students from the university that have to cross from one side of the campus to the other. So there is a constant path of circulation behind us. And that's something that the student had to address. And it was seen as a challenge because we could not cut that. That was very important. So then we work with sort of the, respecting the height, but at the same time, that circulation, keeping it because it's oriented.